Good afternoon and welcome to Grain TV. It's March 4th, 2013. To my left is Logan Burgess and I'm Brock Chimbineau. Let's turn over to Fire Tip to see where we ended the day in Chicago. Corn was down 5 cents, soybeans up 19 and 3 quarters, wheat down 18 and a half in Chicago, and Kansas City was off 18 and 3 quarters as well. If you guys want to try live quotes in your home or office, head over to grainhedge.com and sign up for a free trial. You know, Logan, we did have a pretty interesting trade today. We started the overnight session in positive territory for corn. We're also positive in soybeans, but during the day session, we seemed to trickle a little bit lower, and I think that was driven by the wheat market.
Yeah, absolutely, Brock. If we take a look here at a daily chart here for wheat, this is a daily candlestick chart of the May contract. As you can see here in last week's action, we actually picked up a little bit of steam, certainly not as much as we saw out of the corn or soybean market, but today we really gave back all those gains from last week. We took a pretty darn strong run at $7 a bushel here. The bulls came back in around $7 a bushel. We closed at $7.02, but certainly this is a bearish chart look right now for this wheat market, and if we're able to close below $7 with conviction, really opens the downside here to these lows that we printed really coming into last spring around $6.65. So keep an eye on that. Right now, in terms of wheat, although U.S. wheat is very competitive on the global front, certainly seems like some precip coming into the Western Grain Belt and the Southern Plains seems to be pushing things lower. If we hop in here to a map provided by our friends over at Planalytics, you can see that really a huge swath of key growing areas right now is expected to get precip later this week. And certainly this is the area that people are really concerned about, grain growing areas west of the Mississippi. So fundamentally, this seems to be weighing on things a bit. But as you said, Brock, wheat selling today kind of led to pressure in the corn market. And if we take a look here at a daily chart on corn, you can see that in the overnight session, we came up here, we actually traded up, bumped our head against that 200-day moving average here, and really ended the day negative. So certainly, from a technical standpoint, that's not what people are really looking for. When you see a move higher, end on a move lower, as we're looking here, we see corn down 5 cents. But really, I think this is still a good price target here. These lows around 716 and a half here on the daily chart. Certainly, it seemed like in today's action, the fundamentals for corn seemed to improve a bit. In the overnight session, we had South Korean feed buyers purchasing 140,000 metric tons of old crop corn. And then this morning on top of that, we had a sale to unknown destinations for 100,000 metric tons. So, you know, if you've been watching Grain TV here throughout the marketing year, these are sales that corn really has not been getting in recent weeks. So I think corn bulls out there should be excited about this. As we said, though, with wheat down 20 cents, corn had a really hard time hanging in there today.
You know, I think we have seen better end-user demand recently, especially in the ethanol sector. We've seen that uptick in their production over the last several weeks or so. We've seen those daily sales of corn for export sales. And, you know, really backing that up is some rather slow farmer selling into the cash market. I think that keeps a strong bid under the market, and that's going to flow over into the future market as well. And I think that's what we're seeing here over the last several sessions.
Yeah, Brock, you know, in today's action, we did get another good indicator of export demand by way of the export inspections report. It really looked like it was pretty good showing today for corn, soybeans, and wheat.
Yeah, corn and soybeans actually exceeded expectations on the export inspections. Wheat came right within expectations. If we quickly look over the numbers here, corn exported about 15.7 million bushels, soybeans at 40 million bushels, and wheat came in at 24 million bushels. So strong showing there for corn and soybeans. If you take a look at where we stand for this year on the marketing year, you can see this green line here is what we need to be hitting to on the daily export, or excuse me, weekly export inspections to meet the current USDA projections for soybeans here. The red bars are what we actually are experiencing for exports leaving the country. And that leaves us 211 million bushels ahead of pace to meet the current USDA expectations. That's up another 3 million bushels alone for soybeans this week. If we turn our attention to corn, it's a little bit of a different story over there.
Yeah, absolutely, Brock. As you can see here, throughout the marketing year, we've been building in a deficit here in terms of the reported weekly inspections and the pace needed to meet USDA expectations. Our model's still showing here, we're right now about 52 million bushels short on the pace needed to meet those expectations. That's unchanged from this week, as you can see, or excuse me, unchanged from last week. With this week's data, it was a relatively good showing here for corn, but the bottom line is that we're going to need to keep seeing weekly data like this or better to really make up this deficit here that we've built in throughout most of the marketing year.
Yeah, and you know, those daily sales are really going to help out as we move down the line. We'll have to definitely pay attention to what happens on Thursday with export sales coming out on Thursday morning.
Absolutely. We'll be keeping you posted on that here on Grain TV. But in general, I think that's what we saw here in the grain market for Monday. Visit us over at grainhedge.com to take a free demo of the Fire Tip trading platform, or you can always give us a call here at the office, 877-472-4607. Thanks a lot for tuning in to Grain TV, guys. We'll see you tomorrow.